Welcome to Jackal Digital. I'm Simon, and in today's Quick Twisted Tips video, we'll be making some sounds that can be used to block out. I'll show you how this can be easily done in DaVinci Resolve, and I'll also leave you a link to the sound files that I've made, so you can download them and use them any way you like. Now, when you make a new project, you don't need any files. You only need to go to the Fairlight page. This is where all the audio gets edited. What you'll want to do is create a new audio track. Right click anywhere in this field, add track. You can select any of these options, but I'll go from stereo. Then in the track that we just created, this is A2, select the no input field and select input. Then under the source, find system generator, select it. And then the time code and the beeps don't do anything, but you can choose oscillator, the noise, or both of them. So I will now choose noise, make sure that the audio 2 is selected. If you choose mono, you will only have one channel because it's stereo, it's 2. And then you click patch. This connects the generator to the audio track. So if you don't want it, you can unpatch it. Once you have this done, go to the Fairlight tab at the top, select Test Tone Settings, and put this new window somewhere that it won't bother you. This window allows you to change the settings depending on what kind of audio effect you chose. You have the oscillator settings, some preset frequencies, and the sweep, which basically goes from zero to maximum. Then you have the noise, white noise and the pink noise, and the tone level. Let's see how this sounds. So to test the sound, press the R of the audio that you have set and play with the settings that you have. So in this case I have noise. I'll add another track, this time mono, audio 3, let me extend this, no input, and this time I'll go for oscillator, audio 3, I'll patch it, so now I can listen to it, with the different frequencies. And the sweep then goes automatically from 0 to maximum. But this just means that you're listening to the tone, you don't actually have it on the timeline. So what you have to do, just pause this, like so. So what you have to do is actually listen to the sound, press the record button, leave it for as long as you want, and stop it. And now you can play the sound back. And if you go then to the edit page, you have it in the edit page. One thing that you may have to make sure is that the audio that you want to connect it to is selected. And once it's selected, you can patch it. So now this one will have both the noise and the oscillator. Let's see, stereo, input, system generator, choose both, patch, close. So if you choose stereo, you can have both options. One is on one channel and the other is on the other one. And then you can just step in, right noise. So the 1 kHz frequency that you heard at the start is actually the default, so to speak, when it comes to canceling out words. And with the sweep, we can make something like this. And that's it when it comes to built-in sound generators in DaVinci Resolve. While you can't do a lot with them, it's still faster than searching for a file online. If you found the video helpful, like and subscribe. Hit the bell notification icon so you don't miss my next video. And until next time, Jackals, keep it digital.